The pandemic has pushed our tourism industry to the brink of collapse, and with it, the holiday plans of countless Australians. But one major travel company is now adding to the agony of customers, changing their refund policy.
It was supposed to be the European trip of a lifetime, a chance for two best friends and their five mates to recreate these happy memories.
I was working about 55 to 60 hours just to afford this trip.
But both Caitlin Callahan and Lani Elliott are now thousands of dollars out of pocket, and their chances of getting a refund look grim.
It's kind of lost our trust in lots of agencies because we gave them all our money because we trusted them to do the right thing by us.
In March, Top Deck, one of Australia's biggest youth travel operators, told the students they'd receive a refund for their booking. But then came the email.
The email pretty much just stated that as of 2 days ago, Top Deck had changed their T's and C's and backdated it. So now we were no longer entitled to a full refund, and we could only get a credit.
In a statement to Nine News, Top Deck said they'd adapted their cancellation policy, citing other tour operators to maintain the ongoing financial integrity of the business. But the ACCC says changes cannot be made retrospectively.
They cannot deny those rights and say that whatever applied then no longer applies.
The problem for would-be travellers is that every company and every airline has different terms and conditions and refund policies. Some are offering credit notes, but they need to be used within 1 year of making the booking. And who knows when flights will resume and global travel will be safe again. And so, like coronavirus, confusion is spreading.
If you've lost your job and you just want your money back, it's absolutely understandable, and I would pursue that as patiently as I possibly can.
And get in touch with the Department of Fair Trading in your state. Erlie Walsh, Nine News.